Alrighty, so this is Simon's Quest, the least liked Castlevania game ever made. Specifically, this is Simon's Quest Redacted, which is a fan mod to make the original game playable. That playable is going to be in big open quotes, as we will soon see.
I have a funny story about Castlevania 2 Simon's Quest.
Okay.
The first time I ever played it,
uh-huh.
It was my cousin who had gotten it for his NES.
Okay.
Back when we were both kids. And he bought it secondhand. So it turned out the game was busted.
Oh, like, wow.
It was just broken.
Right.
But we didn't know this. Like, we just thought this was the way the game was.
Right.
So we ended up playing the game. It's like, why? Well, everything's all screwed up. Is this the way it's supposed to be? Then we'd be like, reset the game. Like, we spent like 3 hours just trying to make this game work right. And then we just assumed, I guess this is just the game. And we played it like that.
Right.
It's just like, oh, okay.
Actually still... Ah, shit. That's what I get for waiting. Now it's a wonderful night to have a curse. Oh, God, this game. So let's talk about this game for just a minute. One of the things I absolutely abhor about the early Castlevania games is you have, like, no movement options. Like, you can duck, and you can jump really slowly, and you walk like you are in, you know, fucking physical therapy. Like, you just do not move quickly.
Yeah.
So I don't know that it works as... Oh, fuck. All right. Death 1. Yeah. What were we, like, 3 minutes in?
I don't know. It hasn't happened for me yet.
Okay. Ah! Ah! Nope, there's two. One thing I really like about the redacted version of this game is that... Oh, god damn it, there's three!
Oh, you got in a bad place.
Yeah.
This is not good.
No. It actually changes the checkpoints, so when you die, you revive right where you died instead of going back to the beginning of the screen.
I don't think that was an advantage for you, though.
Not in this case, because it means I revived in range of getting Murloc, man, dude. Fuck! God damn it!
Oh, no.
No! Oh, God!
All I can say is that at the very least, you would still be alive in fact, Xanadu.
And we get Sackroad's wonderful Skype Skype image there.
That's fine. That's everyone can enjoy that.
Yes! I know. Finally, we get some fan service in the stream. Jeez.
Ladies.
Alright, we're back to going.
Yay!
Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and show something off I didn't in the first screen here. Don't go left. I learned that I was doing some, like, really quick test play just to see how much I was gonna suck at this earlier. And do not go left from here for this reason.
It hasn't happened to me yet.
You'll see it. Oh, God, wrecked. Yeah, like, all of the worst monsters are on the left screen.
And oh, no.
Wreck you immediately.
Oh, no. Wow.
I just wanted to show that off, just to show that despite, like, this being fan-modded to hell and back, it is still not a great, fun game to just get into.
I like how you died, you came back, you just, like, you had to flee with
yep.
all of your might. Just,
yep.
That one like guy was, like, directly behind you breathing.
Yeah, they all move at the same speed that I did. Oh, fuck! Yeah. God damn! Fucking shit-ass motherfucker ass mother dick! Oh! Ah! Apologies.
So, having a little problem there?
That was a cluster swear. I don't know. People who haven't met me in real life haven't heard those from me before.
That bat murdered you.
He did. He murdered me hard. Am I supposed to be able to, like, enter the buildings in this area, or is it just, like, a ruined town?
Not at night.
Oh, right.
It's at night.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. No. No. Stop.
Wow, that bat is just like a dog with a bone.
Yeah.
Like, San Andreas story was probably, like, their best attempt at creating an actual story.
Right.
Because Vice City was clearly just, oh, you're Scarface.
Deal with it.
That's pretty much all they did. Scarface, boom, there you go.
Man, I really like Sleeping Dogs for that.
Well,
like,
Sleeping Dogs is good. Don't even get started.
I mean, what else are we going to talk about? We're certainly going to talk about this fucking game.
Yeah,
but
talk about with this game, jeez.
How about them pallets? Sweet pink doors, bro.
Man, there's like nothing in that town but a church.
Yeah. Oh, wow, this is lovely.
Reminds me of the town I grew up in.
You... I swear that you were trying to get yourself killed with that eyeball there.
I am really good at it, haven't you noticed?
I'm gonna place myself between this monster and the water and see what happens.
Yes. These bats are the bane of my fucking existence. Oh no, no, not a curse. I don't want, oh man. Oh jeez.
Oh jeez. The timing on these curses is impeccable.
I don't think there is a, I mean, obviously there's never a good time to have a curse.
Don't even have the thorn whip.
Right? We still don't actually know where the hell to get that, so I guess I just gotta deal with it.
It's in the first town.
Oh, is it? Wow, I'm an idiot. Okay.
Yeah, I guess knew where it was. I thought you knew.
No, I specifically said I didn't. Oh, jeez. Oh, well, that's okay. I can totally make it back to that first town without getting wrecked.
Sure. At night, where yes. You can't get healed, and there's no, like, wall meat.
Yes. No wall chicken, man. What kind of life is it without wall chicken?
Yeah, honestly, what kind of Castlevania game doesn't have wall meat?
I can definitely accept this game hating me, so... Ah! No!
The only healing you get are for, like, the priests in the towns.
Exactly.
And that's like, come on! Like, the one place where you don't really need healing, oh, here, have some health. Like, screw you, game, come on.
It kind of works as far as, like, exploration goes, because it means you push forward to get to the next town, but, man, if you're dying three times before you actually get to that town because you're a skilled player like I am, it doesn't really work. Ah!
It's fine, you're fine! Oh, look at that dead end.
Whip harder. Whip harder. There we go. Alright. I did it.
Whip harder.
Oh god, oh god, oh god. Okay, good, that doesn't actually kill you. Survive the night!
Get out of the goo!
I did! Seriously, I thought it was gonna instantly kill me and like let go of the controls for a minute. That's how skillful I am.
Yeah. I probably should have mentioned that.
Ah! Shit! Fucking eyeballs!
Well, look at it this way. At least you have one more life to go.
Yep. To get wrecked. Ah! Did I really just do that?
Oh.
I do theoretically have enough hearts. I just have to not die again.
Oh, wow. I like how you get back from dying and the first thing you do is jump in the goo.
Yep. I told you, man, I'm a skillful player. Fuck it, I'll just walk through the fucking goo. Ah, there. I took damage to save time. That's totally a speedrunner trick.
You just get past that one area that has a bunch of water in it. That's not a problem, right?
Yeah, I can totally make all of those precision jumps. Be fine. I'll be totally fine. Fuck! Nope. There it is. Diamond just falls like a fucking rock, too.
Yeah. I mean, you know, terminal velocity achieved in 1 second.
Yep. Must be genetic.
Yeah. That Belmont curse. That's the curse they're talking about. Thick ankles.
Yep. That's the one. Definitely not caught in, you know, eternal struggle with Dracula and family.
Nope. Just ankles.
God, what a horrible night to have a curse.
Oh, right here?
Yes, right here.
Oh, jeez.
No! No!
Oh,
okay. We can do it. We can do it. I believe in us.
Oh, God. These fucking mermen.
They are the worst. Ah! I think we've adequately shown off how frustrating this game can be. But it's not this game. Well, that was a good night to die. Alright, here's my favorite screen. Fuck you, mermen. Let's do it.
Oof, I don't think you can make that jump. Oh, I was wrong.
I got lucky. What the... Oh, shit.
What?
I'm trying to... Is there something I can jump on that I'm not seeing here? Once you get there. Oh, I see. Okay, you climb these, like, ladder things. What the hell? That is shitty tile set design.
Ladder things? I think you have boots that are magnetic towards water.
Man, his feet are just becoming more and more magical as we go along.
Yeah. Simon Belmont's got those magic toes.
Ah! Why does everything jump? Okay. Ah! I just fell through a hole in the shit.
Bullshit.
Yeah, that fills me with misery.
Yeah,
and
it's
not determination.
Like, this game is really not good.
Yeah. I think we have made that point.
All right, throw your holy water here.
I am. You've made me forever paranoid about it, so.
Well, I'm just
Oh, that's dirty. The end. And was throwing the whole way, and then the very first part of the next layer up was the false one. Yay.
I'm a font of pointless video game information at times.
I think we all are. Something to do with our upbringing.
This game.
This fucking game.
Yeah.
Oh, man, we made it to the first orb. I was kind of expecting a boss fight. Okay.
Yeah, but here's the problem. You did not buy the wooden stake.
Ah, what? What is that fuck shit? What? okay, I'm done. This, fuck this game. All right.
And it's funny because I sat there and I watched you go past and I was like, oh, she doesn't know about the wooden stakes.
Thank you. Fuck! Yeah, all right. So that's where we're going to end the fail stream this week on the most epic of fails. Thanks, teammate. Really appreciate your support there.
Well, to be fair, you were in the middle of talking. I was like, all right, she's talking. I don't want to interrupt her.
It's all good. Yeah, that I think is the finest example of what Simon's Quest is, where you can struggle to get to the end of the dungeon, but you didn't pick up an item that you didn't know you were supposed to have, and so you don't get to do shit. You get to backtrack through the whole goddamn thing.
Well, to be fair, you're on a screen where you can see the person who sells the wooden stakes, like the below you, and I
right.
figured that's where you were heading, but then you started to go down, and I was like, oh no.
All right, so yeah, that's where we're gonna call it quits. Contact me if you have any recommendations for next week's fail stream. We'll be going at the same time. If you want to be a commentator, let me know. We can set it up. Obviously, thanks to Sack for talking with me and keeping us entertained throughout this stream. Hope you guys had a good time, and I will see you next week.
See you, everybody.